There's just this nervousness right now, and you hold the hands of the thermometer. What does the thermometer tell you right now?
Yeah, the thermometer, the barometer, the liquidity
thermometer.
Is basically...
I like that better than thermometer. We're all meteorological here.
Yeah, exactly. It may be this transition from winter to springtime, but it's really going to be a rough transition. And really, it focuses on this change in the cost of capital, both in nominal terms that we've seen over the past 9 rate hikes, which people have clearly rationalized back in the fourth quarter of last year. But more importantly, the change in the relative value of capital. So capital will continue to increase, and more importantly, as risk-free rates at 2.4% get put in place with risk assets, investors, CFOs, treasurers are going to have to figure out how to make proper capital allocations.
Oh, my word, like the old times. So what you're saying is Lawrence Culp of GE, David Weston's great conversation with him, we'll show much of that through the day here, or the guy at BMW, or name the company, it's back to the real world.
It's back to the real world with the overlaying complexity of politics and fiscal policy that we're going to have to look forward to over the next few years. So it's definitely a lot more complicated world. And while monetary policy will likely continue to provide some type of warm blanket to at least extend the runway of economic factors over the next year or so, the reality is that investors need to be prepared for a little bit more volatility to some of these left-tail events. And so simply put, even though you just pointed to the VIX that was back to the lows from the peak in 2014, there could be these mini bouts of illiquidity that get translated to broader concerns in the marketplace. So whether you're an investor or a CFO, those concerns can be pretty significant to the way you manage business and make investments.
Okay, Jerome, give me a sense of how long actually the Fed has elongated the cycle in the U.S. and what that actually means to then start normalizing. The longer, the lower for longer, does it make it much more difficult to then get out of it?
Yeah, it's a great question. And ultimately, we're going to get a little more clarity with the Fed meeting next week. Obviously, there's not going to be a policy change, so we're going to stay right here between 2.25 and 2.5%. But ultimately, when the Fed thinks about it, what they've done is preserve optionality for themselves. Creating this reaction function whereby there's a little bit more symmetry to the inflation policy allows them to provide a longer runway for this economic cycle to grow. And with that in time, they don't necessarily need to react once inflation starts moving higher from 1.7 to 1.8 to 1.9 and well above 2%. So the trajectory for potential rate hikes is a little bit elongated as well. So think about it as a healing process. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer to heal. The Fed's allowing the financial conditions, which were very severe last year, to heal. And as a result, we're going to have this elongated sort of passive response function from the Fed where they're going to continue to emphasize patience. I would think that it's probably more important for investors to look at the underlying tones, recognizing that this transition from monetary policy to simply looking at reducing their balance sheet is going to be one that's not so smooth, but yet at the same time, don't confuse the patience from the Fed as being complacency from the Fed. They're still going to be vigilant in terms of monitoring the data.
Where do you see the 2-year yield by the end of the year?
Where's the 10-year yield? Probably.
I was going to say 2, but you can
the 2-year. Very well. The 2-year yield is probably slightly higher from here. When you look at rate policy, clearly the market is pricing in rate cuts. And at PIMCO, we don't necessarily believe that's a right trajectory, especially in the near term for rates to be heading. Probably more a little bit more agnostic with regard to maybe flatlining for the next 6 to 12 months, maybe even a slight bias upward if data and, more importantly, inflation necessitate. But right now, a rate cut into the market doesn't seem a logical response as the market's pricing in right now. So I would say slightly higher from where we are right here at 245.